ultimately, I think it comes down to if Penny chooses, if she's gonna live or die.
I've cried at nights about it sometimes. If she continues in this fashion, she could die.
We need to do a quick pit stop.
Premium chicken sandwich.
Crispy or grilled?
Crispy or grilled?
Crispy.
Grilled?
Crispy.
Oh, I'm sorry, make that crispy.
I think that she's total denial.
A little bit of lunch. We all needed it so bad.
I'm just hoping that this will be the turning point. I just don't know if she's ever gonna lose the weight.
This has to be the longest drive in history. We gambled with every resource my family has financially. We've had friends, families, neighbors, people donating to us. Honestly, if this is a fail, the failure is catastrophic.
Penny.
Hey, how are you?
I'm Bethany Zardin.
Hi.
Are you glad you're here now?
I have to tell you, doctor, when you and I spoke, you ended the call with, I'm gonna help you. And that meant everything to me. Those words gave me the strength to come.
We'll take care of you. You're gonna be all right.
I'm looking forward to start this process because right now when I look at a timeline for my future, it's short.
Oh, God.
I just have to be ready for everything head on.
Oh.
Penny is very large, but to know her situation, I need to examine her and see how much she weighs. We're gonna check your weight now, okay?
This is the largest fish in the market.
Okay. A normal body mass index is about 20. 35 is morbidly obese. Over 40 is super morbid obese. And here is 85.7.
That's very big.
Let me check a couple things on you, okay? Okay, that's good. Can you move your feet for me?
Well, yes and no.
Can you turn the oxygen off?
I'm on oxygen 24 hours a day.
But if your oxygen saturation is better than mine, why do you need to have oxygen?
I don't know the technical reason, but at 20 minutes, my fingers and lips get blue. Like right now, I'm starting to be very uncomfortable without the oxygen.
Okay, we will turn it back on, okay?
Yeah.
Penny got a lot of issues. Some of them are real, some of them are imaginary. She seems like she played a role of being a victim and encouraging family to be enabler. And this dynamic is very difficult to break.
Ms. Jones?
That's true.
I've been working hard this past month to lose weight. I hope that I'm approved for surgery this time.
That's not good.
I thought the number would be lower. It's a real shock to see the weight gain.
So you managed to gain 17.
Yeah.
What precipitated that?
I don't know exactly. I mean, I know my legs are filled up with fluid right now. And because I was moving here, we've not eaten the foods that we normally were eating that you had me eating.
Well, there's no way this is gonna be a successful weight loss surgery with your making excuses. This is not a very good sign, gaining 17 pounds. You clearly have eating disorder.
I cannot approve your surgery now.
Paula knows what to do, but she's making excuses.
This is very important that you understand the limitation of surgery.
Unless you change your frame of mind, you're not going to do well with the surgery.
And do you have a hernia too?
I do. And it looks like I have a creature growing in my stomach.
Paula needs bypass surgery, and it would be ideal to fix her hernia at the same time. But Paula is not ready for surgery.
We need to put you on liquid diet, okay?
Okay.
She needs to lose 20 pounds and show me that she can make changes regarding her diet. Otherwise, I cannot give her surgery.
So the clock is running now.
Okay. I'm angry at myself because I'd expected something different. But I think I agree with him. I think it is a food disorder. It's actually kind of a relief to hear somebody else say it. My husband used to say that stuff only happens to you that you let it happen to you.
It's hard when you haven't put yourself first. And you're right, our kids have to come first. When you are your healthiest, you will take better care of them. And they will be healthy too. But you will be so much better for them when you matter too. She doesn't feel that she matters, and it's very hard for her to take center stage.
I didn't realize now it's time for me to take care of me and make sure I get myself right.
You gonna put this in the glove compartment for me?
Yeah.
Since you're going on that side.
Today we're going shopping for the kids. I'm not going in there for just like one item. And it's gonna be aisle to aisle to aisle, and I can't walk it. My trainer told me to walk more and stay active. And I'm really trying.
Come on, baby.
But I still need to use my scooter. My knees have been bothering me. I can hardly walk. I work out at the gym, and I'm always walking around the house. I'm not used to moving around so much.
I'm not ready for it.
I can't change overnight.
Four, two, five.
Start. They're
bigger and they're prettier.
Changing something like my eating habits is never going to be easy.
No, my house is not a trampoline.
Because I'm used to doing what I know.
Okay, letting you know now.
I may cheat a little bit here and there, but I'm really trying. It's not just about when my stomach says I'm done. It's about when my head says I'm done. So it's hard to stop. Changing something like eating habits is just really, really hard. Today I'm at the doctor's office. I hope I've lost the weight my doctor wanted and get approved for skin surgery.
Yeah, I'm lost anyway.
I don't know what's going on, but I'm doing things I'm supposed to. I even walked a whole department store.
You're still eating too many calories for your metabolism. That's why you're not losing weight.
You can preach and preach and preach. I don't eat nothing I'm not supposed to.
Well,
things I used to eat, I don't eat anymore.
If the patient doesn't want to change, they will convince themselves that they're not eating very much. Most of these patients are pathological eaters, and they lie to you. But the reality is, to maintain such a high weight, they have to eat a lot.
We were looking forward to having her stomach removed.
We can't remove the skin if she doesn't lose the weight first. If Tara hasn't lost any weight next time she's here, I'm afraid that's going to be end of her weight loss. Tara, we need to get you back on track now. If you can, there's nothing more I can do for you.
Do you understand what he told you?
Yes, I understand. I'm gonna starve myself for 2 weeks to make everybody happy. I'm done with this. I quit. I'm done. Go to my house.